Does fire purify? Yes, it does. And draw, you know, they take fire and they turn up the heat when they're purifying gold. And the hotter it is, the purer the gold. And then the person who's the craftsman begins to scoop away the dross, and that's the part that comes out of the gold. And to make it more pure, they turn up the heat, they turn up the fire. And the worker makes it so that the dross gets removed, and that's the part that gets burned away, the part that's useless. So he's removing in you the chaff that is useless. He's bringing forth the harvest. He's looking for people who will have the mind of Christ and watch and see that the Lord is good. Nothing is impossible. He's preparing people right now that you'll be able to talk to if you're willing. He's setting it up right now. Some of you need a job. He's already prepared the job. If you just get into faith and believe for it and say, Lord, I received that job by faith. I'm not going to worry about it. He said that I don't have to worry. What? Oh, you provide for the birds of the air and the lilies of this field and how much more valuable. Oh, yeah. That's a good word. Don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow has enough worries as well. Oh, yeah, I like that. Okay. Yeah. Does the heart just automatically burn for lost souls? No. Does a heart automatically burn for lost souls? No! I was born into the world whining and crying. I got a little older, I said, won't talk about me, won't talk about my, won't talk about number one, need my, oh my, what I like, what I want, what I see. I like talking about you usually, but occasionally, you won't talk about me. I mean, come on! We gotta get over ourselves. We gotta get the mind of Christ so ingrained in us that we think the way he thinks, so that we'll do the things that he wants us to do and say the things he wants us to say. And who cares if the world gets ticked off? We're not here for the world. We're here for him. The world did not buy you with blood, but Jesus did. Oh, come on, he's got a burning heart. All of heaven is attracted to the Jesus in you. And he's looking down. He's saying, there she is. There he is. My beloved. In my love, please. Come on. Let's do this. I love 2 Kings 1:10. If you remember the story, Elijah said, if I am a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume you 50. And consume. And then the fire fell from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Do you guys know that story? That's a pretty amazing story. That's a good way. God will validate you. God will validate you. If he sends you, then you've got power. Because he would never send you without power.
Amen.
If he asks you to do it, do you really think he's going to go, oh, but let me hold back on all the gifts of the Spirit to help you get it done? And sometimes we're over here and we're like, okay, Lord, I'm gonna be used by you, but that's not my gift. And the Lord's like, wait a minute. So you're saying I would send you to fail? Come on, if he says do this, and you just say, oh, yes, Lord, thank you. If he says support this in this way, and do that, and do this, and go there, and say this, and do that, and come to me. All those commands are opportunities. And sometimes we go, oh, I don't know if that's a good idea. Obedience is always a good idea. Amen. To not obey is rebellion, and rebellion is witchcraft, and witchcraft is to create apart from the Creator who made you. Yeah. The Lord does not want witchcraft in any shape or form to rule and reign in a body that's empowered by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So then don't ever come up creative ideas how you can live your own life apart from God. It's not your life anymore. It's His. He paid for it. Let Him redeem what He bought. By walking in obedience, by resisting the devil. The Bible says, resist the devil and then he flees.
Yes.
He didn't say resist the devil because then he won't bother you. No, he said resist the devil, right? He said stand firm then. And having done all to stand, stand firm still. So when the devil comes knocking on your door, that's when you can go, Lord, thank you. You're with me. What would you have me to do? You know, the only safety is obedience.
Amen.
When things get worse, and they will,
things are really getting better because we're getting closer to the end that's really the new beginning. And so the world's messed up. But if you're saved, you're going to live forever. What are you worried about? No weapon formed against you is allowed to prosper. And if it does prosper, it's going to work out for good. Because he said all things work together for good according to those who love him. Do you love him? Something about to go good for you. Something about to take place that you'll be able to rejoice in. There's a lot of talk about different things going on in the world. And I really get excited because if I have fear, then I ask myself, well, why am I fearful of that? And then I realize, oh, because I need to shift my perspective. If you're afraid of something that you can't control, then chances are you need more love. And if you need more love, come to the loving Father. He just thinks you're amazing. Sit in his presence. Just come to him and say, Lord, I'm with you. Lord, I love you. What do you want me to do? And he might just tell you, don't do anything. Just stay right where you are. Just keep your ears open. Let me love on you. Here's what I say about you. I foreknew you. I've called you. I predestined you. I called you a son. I called you a daughter. You're one of me. We're one and the same. See, we're abiding right now as we commune, as we communicate, as we walk together, as I remind you of what I've promised. Nothing will be impossible for you. Call forth what's lacking. When I call you, come. When I send you, go. Remember not to be burdened. Give me your burden. Cast your cares on me before I care for you. And he just begins to speak to you these wonderful things. He's not going to say, oh, if you would only get busy, if you just do a little more, then you could get more approval. I think you ought to get more religious. Maybe you ought to memorize your scripture so you can use it as a weapon against people. Come on, lock and load, baby. Fire and brimstone, break down the house. Oh, wayward tongues will do it. Gossip and slander is from the devil. We got to be edifying and uplifting. We have to look for somebody to encourage. This morning, God sent me somewhere I didn't want to go. I went. And I was glad. I didn't want to do it, but I went. And guess what? It was good. You know why it was good? Because I was doing what God had asked me to do. And it was a blessing. Because it's a blessing. Anytime he sends you to do something you don't want to do, because he knows more than you. Otherwise, you would have birthed him instead of him birthing you. What do you want to say? I am. How did you know? How did you know? Oh, yeah. The Lord told me to call down fire today. Who wants some of that? Oh, come on, baby. And the Lord showed her prophetically that that's what God asked me to do. And she felt the need to remind me just in case I might have forgotten. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. That's cool. I love how God rolls. You guys ready? I want you to just stand up right now because you're going to receive fire from heaven. You're going to be a contagious Christian from now on. You're not going to be lukewarm. You're not going to fear man anymore. You're not going to fear failure because you're already a success. You're going to embrace the power of God and you're going to move in the fullness of heaven. Angels are going to surround you and begin to stir the people and your friends and your family and your sphere. And guess what? There's going to be new life that comes because you said, here I am, Lord. Here I am. Use me. The prayer of Isaiah. Here I am, Lord. So just say it. Say, Lord, here I am. Use me. Thank you that you're a consuming fire. I release fire from heaven right now. All over this place. Fire. Fire. Fire from heaven. Fall down on the saints of God. Fire. Fire. Fall down. Fire from heaven. Just say, Lord, I receive your fire. I guarantee you're receiving the fire right now. Yeah, when you say that prayer, there's no way you're going to stay the same. The Lord's releasing a spiritual fire right now. It's coming down from the top of heaven all the way down to the base of your feet. And I release it in Jesus' name. He's glad to do it. It's his will.
Amen. Just get prepared to start speaking those things that are not as though they are. They shall be according to the word of God, according to the will of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I guarantee you, this whole place is charged with heaven. The whole place is charged with heaven. Heaven is targeting you. It's targeting the Jesus in you. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were dancing in the flames. And they came out not even smelling like smoke. And it's going to be the same with you. The saints of the Lord by the grace of God. Hallelujah.
Fiery heart of love.
There it is on the screen.
I mean, who would go and die for a righteous man? Who would die for a good person? Would you go hang on a cross for a friend? There's no friend that sticks closer than a brother like Jesus. He said, no greater love than this, than he that would lay his life down for a friend or for another. Oh man, I have a feeling that some of you are never going to be the same. This isn't a religious show. This isn't a dog and pony show. This is the kingdom of heaven and the reality of his beginning invasion on the earth. He's about to move a remnant into full-on revival, which means to make hearts that burn with the passion of heaven to do the will of the Father are going to see it. Hallelujah. Luke 12:49 says, you can be seated if you like. Luke 12:49. How many people felt the fire? Come on, let me see your hands. Who felt the fire? Come on, that's some fire right there. Praise the Lord. How many people got healed? Let me see if you got healed. Put your hands up. Give them 2 hands so I can see. Who got healed? Okay. Anybody? You got healed? You got healed? Okay. Who needs a healing right now? Because I promise you, God's about to give it to you. Watch. Just put your hand up if you need a healing. Okay, now watch this. Keep your hands up. Keep them up. Now, the rest of you, you're the intercession team. We're going to pray. God's going to move. That's how it works. You got the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead. That's resurrection power flowing through your veins. Hallelujah. Keep your hands up. Now, the rest of you, join me in prayer for those who have their hands raised. Come on. In the name of Jesus, we release the fire of heaven. Say it with me. I release the fire of heaven on those who need a touch from God. Be released into your freedom right now in Jesus' name. And all over the room, the Spirit is beginning to touch you. And he's beginning to transform you. And he's beginning to move out the dross and those things that hinder. He's blowing out the chaff right now in the name of Jesus. He does not desire that any should perish, but all have eternal life, that would receive the gift of salvation with gladness and with joy. I release the Spirit of God over you in Jesus' name. Backs are being healed. Necks are being transformed. Mindsets of limitation and destructive patterns are being liberated. Chains are falling off of addiction to all kinds of things. Pharmakia, from drugs and alcohol, from sexual addictions, from pornography, from cigarettes. Hallelujah. You're delivered in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, I give you that. Whatever it is you don't want, you say, Lord, I give you that. And he'll gladly take it from you. And even the desire and even the hooks that the devil put in you to try to keep you from the plan of God. And we say all ties to the demonic are severed in the name of Jesus. We bind every foul spirit in the name of Jesus. We say burn up any ropes or ties to the past, Lord. Depression is under the blood of Jesus. Loneliness and despair is under the blood of Jesus. Witchcraft and mind control under the blood of Jesus. Salvation is at hand and deliverance has come nigh. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, glory to the Lamb. Come on. Whoa, I'm feeling some fire up here, man. I don't know what to do. I think I might have to sit down. Right? Okay, Luke 12:49. I have come. Can you read this with me? I have come to cast fire upon the earth. And how I wish that it were already kindled. Oh, that's so powerful. The Lord's saying, he has come to cast fire upon the earth. That's amazing. What does fire do? Well, we remember that strange fire is when we grieve the Holy Spirit. But His holy, righteous fire, His heavenly fire comes to purify and to draw us close, to remove what hinders, to release people into destiny. Sometimes we've got to get some ropes and some ties to the past completely burned off so our hands can begin to praise Him. Some of you have a hard time worshiping God. You know why? Because there's some idols in your life, some things that are more important to you than Him. And if you identify it, don't be condemned. He said you're not condemned, but He brings you into an awareness so that you can evaluate. You can judge yourself in a good way to evaluate what needs to be adjusted. And if you do that, then He won't have to. And it'll go a lot easier for you. So judge yourself from a position of evaluation and say, what is it, Lord, that's keeping me from a deep and passionate and fiery and all-in empowered relationship with You? And maybe you're feeling like, maybe I missed God. Maybe I need to get back on track. All you have to do is just say, Lord, thank You. That's not who I am. I'm a child of God. I was born for this. I was born for such a time as this. This is the beginning of an end time move of the Holy Spirit that we have never seen. That's why He said, eyes not seen, nor ear heard, nor has it entered in the heart of man those things that I have prepared for those who love Me. That's the Lord. He says, if you love Me, then He's prepared things that you haven't even hoped for.
Amen.
That's a good word. I love that He said, and how I wish that it were already kindled. Do you know if it was up to the Lord and there was no free will, then He would have every church in a state of constant revival. He would have every person and every participant in the church today so outrageously on fire, walking in such a passion and walking in such a freedom that liberty would be the result of every breath that they took on this earth. It's true. But it's not quite there, because it says here, and how I wish that it were already kindled. So He's basically saying, no, it's not already kindled, but it's about to get kindled. And that's why He wanted to talk about fire, because He's beginning to breathe on the flame that is here. I just see like you guys are little fires, a bunch of little fires right here. And the Holy Spirit's coming up and He's just going, have you ever got frustrated blowing on your campfire and you're like, man, the wood's wet, I don't even know what to do, and the Lord's going, it's not going to stop Me. I'm going to breathe on you even if you are wet. And when He calls fire down from heaven, it doesn't matter if the wood's wet, because it's supernatural. Yeah, just ask the Lotto. And that brings me to my next one. So Matthew 3:12 says, but the chaff, He will. Wait a minute, maybe if you're good enough? No? Oh, yeah, you're right. It says, but the chaff, He will burn up with fire that cannot be put out. Say, my fire cannot be put out. So I will burn brighter and hotter with holy fire that the world will be a better place.